Okay, so I'm gonna get started. I wanted to thank everyone who is here today from what we see is all across the country. That's very exciting. You're actually technically in Las Cruces, New Mexico and Las Vegas, Nevada, with myself and our staff here at the University Art Museum. And we're really excited for Justin Favela's workshop. Justin is one of the artists who is participating in just one of the exhibitions that we have opening up in our spring exhibitions at the University Art Museum in January 21st of 2021. And Justin's exhibition, which is a two-person exhibition, which originated at the Marjorie Barak Museum of Art in the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, will travel here and will open up on January 21st with a really lovely talk between myself and Alicia Curlin, who worked with Justin and Romero Gomez on Sorry for the Mess. We're gonna speak at 6 p.m. as part of the opening. And then the second part of the opening will be, we have a show within our Bonnie Conlon gallery called Pasos Aenos. And that exhibition there'll be a talk right after myself and Alicia's talk with the creators of that exhibition, which are Dr. Dulcinea Lara, who teaches at NMSU with Dr. Nicholas Natividad, and also and the exhibit designer, Daniel Aguilera. So that's gonna be a really exciting night, and that will be the night of January 21st. Also opening it on that night will be an exhibition called St. Joseph and the Laborers, which was curated by Courtney Aldridge, one of our students, graduate students in the University Art Museum. Courtney has some great events that are gonna happen as part of that exhibition as well. But that will be in our Retablo Gallery and will feature Joseph and different saints who are laborers within the Mexican Retablo tradition. I wanted to just thank really quickly a couple of people who have helped make this night happen. The Community Foundation of Southern New Mexico, the Devastali Family Foundation Fund, the Marjorie Barak Museum of Art and all of their staff, and especially Alicia Curlin, the US Bank and Wells Fargo, who helped support our OutSmart programs. And then of course, our staff here at the University Art Museum, who have, through COVID and all the different events that we've been doing, have helped us so greatly open and close the museum and open and close the museum. So without further ado, I would like to introduce Justin Favela. And Justin's gonna speak a little bit about the show, but I just wanna introduce him. Justin was born in 1986 in Las Vegas, Nevada, and he's an alumni of UNLV. And Favela works primarily in large-scale installations, sculptures that playfully lift up the impactful childhood objects and amplify them to us, to make everyone understand and think about childhood and be part of different forms of art installations. Favela has exhibited his work both internationally and across the United States. His installations have been commissioned by museums, including the Denver Art Museum in Colorado, Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art in Arkansas, and he is the recipient of the 2018 Alan Turing LGBTIQ Award for International Artists. He is also a phenomenal podcaster, and you must listen to these podcasts, Latino Who Lunch and the Art People podcast, which we'll also have as part of this exhibition that's coming up. Justin, thank you so much. We are so excited for this workshop. Without any further ado, I will mute myself and go for it.
Wow, what an intro. Thank you. Okay, well, first I want to tell you a little bit about the exhibition. Last year or 2 years ago, 3 years ago, time doesn't matter anymore. I don't know when it happened. But previously here in Vegas, my friend Ramiro and I did a show about our experiences as children here in Las Vegas. His family is from California, Southern California, and they would come here all the time. And my family, they immigrated here in like the 70s and 80s from Guatemala and from Mexico. And they've worked on the Las Vegas Strip ever since I could remember, in all the casinos. And so a lot of the history about Latinos in Las Vegas isn't really told, isn't really recorded. And I really wanted to pay homage to the people that built Las Vegas, the people that maintain Las Vegas, and the people that are really working behind the scenes to make it the you know, one of the most, you know, I think, iconic tourist attractions in the United States, right? So today we're gonna focus on some plants that we made for the exhibition that's based on this story of Ramiro's father, who was a truck driver who would drive exotic plants from California all the way to Las Vegas for the Mirage, where Secret and Roy eventually had a show. They're the ones that had the White Tigers. And then he personally had a relationship with Siegfried and Roy, and would deliver their plants for their landscaping at their house and stuff. So stories like that are so familiar here in Las Vegas. Everybody knows, you know, some big celebrity on the strip and has a personal relationship with him. I'm kind of friends with Siegfried, which is a weird thing that's happened over the last couple of years. I don't know how it happened, but he knows who I am, and I see him sometimes I used to see him once in a while, because I like going over to the secret garden where the tigers are, because I have a friend that's a dolphin trainer. See, this is like Vegas stories, right? So we're going to pay homage to that today, and so one of the parts of the exhibition is a portrait that Ramiro painted of his father, and then I thought, well, why don't we recreate a nursery to kind of symbolize those plants that would travel from California to Las Vegas. And that kind of tied the relationship between Ramiro and I and Las Vegas in one like beautiful installation. So when you go to the exhibit at the museum, you're gonna see the portrait, you're gonna see a bunch of plants that I had already made for the exhibition. But most of those plants that you're gonna see are made from volunteers or people that just went to the museum and felt inspired and made them. So we're gonna continue that here with y'all. So the kits that you're getting, when you make the plants, you can take them back to the museum and they will become part of the garden, part of the nursery at NMSU Art Museum, which is so cool. So I just love a living installation that just keeps growing over time. And that's kind of the idea behind this. And a lot of my art focuses on my identity as a Latinx queer person in the United States, right, in the Southwest. And I really like this idea of making something out of nothing, right? Or what people perceive as nothing, as kind of this, nod to my parents and to the people that really came here with very little and kind of built a life for them and their families from whatever they could, right? So a lot of the materials that you have are really easy to find around the house. And so I'm gonna show you the basic materials that we're gonna use today. So if you already picked up your kits, you already have some cardstock. If you don't, oh, hold on, let me start recording on my phone so we get some close-ups for later. All right, so if you already got your kits, you have some cardstock in there. I only had white cardstock at my house, but I made some green cardstock by gluing tissue paper to white cardstock. So here's my cardstock right here. And I have about, I don't know, 5 or 6 sheets that I'm gonna use and we're gonna cut up today. And then a stapler. Most people have staplers. And then some glue, regular all glue, Elmer's glue, or a glue stick. I think everybody got a glue stick. And then some cardboard. This will eventually be a planter or a pot. But if you already have like a little container, that's what we can use. And then tissue paper. I have brown tissue paper because I like to use the brown tissue paper as like dirt for the plant. And so I'm gonna show you how to do 2 basic shapes today for these paper plants. If you wanna go along, I'm gonna try to slow down so you can come, you know, do it along with me. But they're fairly simple. And you can always zhuzh them up after this workshop and make them even bigger, keep adding to them, clean them up, whatever you'd like. So the first thing we're gonna do is create the base, the pot, the planter. And so I have a strip of cardboard like this big. And if it's, this is gonna be basically the height of your planter. So you wanna make sure that it's not too tall, unless you want like a really tall vase looking thing. So this is about maybe like 3-4 inches. And if you wanna trim it down, depending on how thick the cardboard is, you can always, you know, just trim it down to whatever size you want. All right, so I'm not gonna do this with hot glue. I'm just gonna do it with the materials that I said. I also have tape right here. I don't think I mentioned the tape. And so the first thing I'm gonna do is just take the cardboard and start kind of squishing it together and also just kind of rolling it so that it's more malleable so you can actually make it into a cylindrical shape. So I'm just kind of pressing it and creasing it and kind of moving down. Oh my gosh, y'all are doing it with me. This is so cool. Yay, thanks Rachel. This is awesome. Okay, so then once you kind of get it squishy and like creased up like that, it'll fold into a cylinder pretty easy. And so at this point you could hot glue it together, you could staple it together. I'm just gonna tape it together with some clear tape. So I'm just taping it, really simple. And this is gonna be our little pot that we're gonna put all the plants in. I'll put another piece of tape just to make sure it's really stuck on there. Fold it over the edge so that it doesn't pop open. And are some of y'all gonna take this plant to the museum as part of the show? If you want the plant back, I think people can come get them, right? Make sure you write your name at this point on the pot so you don't forget, all right? So I'm just gonna grab a Sharpie and put my name on it. I'll just put my initials on it. I want this back, Marissa, okay? So, okay. So then we have our little pot. Very simple. All right, next we're gonna work on the leaves. And this is the funnest part for me. So I'm gonna take my cardstock, and usually I just freehand it, but for educational purposes, I'm gonna draw out the shape. And so it's kind of like a generic tropical plant / palm tree shape that I'm going to show you how to do that I think looks really cool. And then the next one we're going to do is more of like a spiky plant, almost like an aloe. So this one's going to be a little bit more tropical. So very Siegfried and Roy, secret garden kind of vibes. And then the next one will be more desert. Okay. So, all right. So I'm going to take one sheet and show you, take this one. And I'm just gonna draw a big like leaf, like generic leaf shape or like almond shape. Let me show you. Like this. Can you see it? Let me do it a little thicker so you can see it. Almost like when you're like sad in middle school and you draw eyes crying, it's like an eye shape. Okay. And then actually we're gonna cut this out next. So the way that I do it to save time is I'll stack my paper. I'm gonna do three sheets. I'm gonna do three at a time. And then I'm gonna grab my scissors. And the Catholic grandma in me is like, wow, that's very wasteful. You drew it right in the center. You can draw, you can actually get like two leaves out of one if you want. But for the purposes of this, that's why I drew it right in the middle so you could see it easier. But you can do multiple leaves per page if you'd like. You don't have to be this big either. All right. Yeah, and it doesn't have to be green either. If you have different colors, plants come in all colors. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut the plant, the leaves out of the three layers. And you know what? I think I'm gonna make this one a little bit more full. So I'm gonna cut the same shape out of the remaining two sheets that I have here. Gonna freehand this one. Some people like to put little stems at the end of them to make them easier to put into the pot. I don't find it necessary, but all right. So this one's a really weird organic shape, so it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay. Now what I do to give this leaf a little bit more structure is I will fold the leaf in half. So my paper is really thick, so I'm just gonna go one at a time and just fold it in half this way, long ways, hot dog style. And what this is doing, it's like making a kind of a triangle shape like this. So it's giving the leaf a more like more structural integrity so that it'll stay, you know, standing up and it won't be all floppy and look dead when you put it in your pot. Okay. So I have all my leaves folded now, and now I'm gonna just stack the original three that I cut first, and I have them stacked again. And now I'm gonna make some very deliberate cuts to make this look more like a palm tree. So I'm gonna try drawing this backwards so y'all can see it, and then I'll hold it up. I'm gonna do the lines really thick so you can see. From the center fold, I leave about, so this is the, here, I'll draw it on this one. So here's this, that's the center of the leaf, right? So we're gonna leave about half an inch from the end, and I'm just gonna draw lines going up. So this dotted line in the middle is just to show you where the fold is, but you could see the, you could see how the, they're kind of diagonal there. And so I'm gonna use those as a guide and just cut along those lines. I'm gonna do it on one just to show you on the first one. So I'm just gonna cut along the lines. Don't cut all the way to the middle because that kind of creates a stem for you. And so you can see here when I cut it, you can kind of fold it around and it starts to look more like a leaf from a palm tree or like a big, you know, like a beautiful house plant. To give it a little more drama, you can actually cut right underneath it so that there's more negative space and it'll create it like a, like, you know how people like those, I don't remember what those plants are called, but those big leafy indoor plants. If you cut, I'm trying to get the right angle to show you guys, but here, I'll just keep cutting. So I'm just cutting, you can see here, just like little slivers out. Instead of just cutting a line, you can just like cut a little triangle out. And now when I open it, it's like very dramatic. You can see the cuts in the leaf. So I'm gonna do that to the rest of the leaf so that they all match. And once you get the hang of it, you're not gonna have to draw, you don't have to draw the shape. You kind of just, you can just go with the flow and make it your own. So I'm just gonna stack all these together and do it all at once. You know, I'm left-handed, but I cut with my right hand, which is so weird because I'm really clumsy at cutting, but it's better than my left hand for some reason, probably because I don't have any left-handed. I had to grow up using right-handed scissors. And if you cut all the way to the middle, it's all right, don't worry about it. And then these little scraps, if you want to put like little grass, it almost looks like little pieces of grass. You can use that later for this plant or for another one. Some people get really fancy with this and do like a bunch of cuts and it looks like a fan, you know? Like one of those fan palm trees, which is really cool. All right, so that's these two. A little different. They're like a little bit thinner, the shape of these. And then I'm gonna make these ones similar, but I'm gonna put a little bit more negative space in the leaf to make it look like, you'll see, like more triangular. You see that? All right. Almost. All right, so then these are these leaves here. So they're all a little bit different, but they're gonna be part of the same plant. Okay. This is a little tip. If you wanna give your plant a little bit more dimension, notice I did like a Kelly green on one side and then I did a dark green on the other, just so if you wanna paint your leaves or your cardstock beforehand, if you wanna make a different one, you can do that. Okay. So I'm gonna take my five leaves now and I'm gonna adhere them or staple them to the pot. So at this point, if you're using regular paper, tissue paper, you can just like use a glue stick or use regular glue. For me though, because it's faster and I'm lazy, I like to use a stapler. So I just take the leaves. And then I have my base, the pot that we had already made. And then I'm just gonna strategically just staple the end of the leaf right on the side of the pot. So just right on the inside lip of it there, and just one of the edges of the leaf, very simple. And you just kinda go back and forth. I usually put like two in, like to put on the base, give it a little weight like that. And then you can also take the leaves and kind of make a cool organic shape in your hand, staple the leaves together. So I'm gonna take these three and make kind of this cool fan shape like this. You can staple those together or glue them together. I'm gonna put in a few on this one. And you have this, and then you can take your glue stick and put a little glue on here. And since these leaves are already in here, I'm just gonna kind of put them in and make sure that the glue is touching these leaves. I see that this cardstock is really thick and maybe the glue is not going to work too well with this one. I think yours is a little bit thinner than mine. So I'm just going to put in a few more staples to adhere these, to stick these leaves onto these so it doesn't move or it doesn't, you know, flop out. So just a couple staples. It doesn't take much. And then You have your little plant in your pot. A little house plant that you don't have to water. And then the finishing touch for right now, because you can add a flower. This kind of looks like a bird of paradise, right? So you could like add a flower on the top, but you have your brown tissue paper. And this is the best part. You could just crumple it up. Crumple up your brown tissue paper. And you just kind of, you can also place it in there. And this helps also kind of keep the leaves together. Some people like to dip the tissue paper in glue to make like rocks and like that all holds everything together. So this is really filling up the base of this. And at this point you can kind of arrange it like how you want it, like a flower arrangement. I like it like this. And so that's this one. So y'all can keep working on this one, and I'm really quick, I'm gonna make the spiky one so you can see how to make those. But if y'all wanna keep working on these more tropical ones, I'll show you really quick how to make the spiky ones. This one actually turned out really nice. I'm like surprising myself, like, wow, that looks like a plant. And what we did for the other exhibition was paint these black, because you know like when you go to a nursery, they're usually painted black. You can do that. I think that just having the cardboard is really cool too. But you can personalize it if you want. If you want to, you know, paint them bright colors, whatever you'd like. So I'm going to put this on the side and show you how to make the next one. So like Marissa said, you can just use stuff you have laying around the house. As you can see, I have a lot of stuff laying around my house because I don't throw anything away. And I'm not a hoarder. I just like to collect things and stack them up really high, okay, in my garage. All right, so I just got a package today in this little box, and it's like the perfect size to make a plant, like a little square pot. So I'm just gonna take my scissors and cut the flaps off. Actually, you don't even have to cut the flaps off. You can just fold them in, and there you go. Look at that, even easier. If you have like a plastic cup from a restaurant that you're not using, you can paint that cup black or wrap paper around it. If you have like, you know, sometimes you get like little berries, like blackberries in a little container, you can stuff that with tissue paper and use it as your base. Like anything that kind of resembles a pot or a planter that you can stuff stuff into it, you can use it for this. So I'm just gonna use this as my base. This is like a very chic, like modern planter made out of concrete or something. Okay, and this is the cool part about the spiky plants is that you can use the scraps from other stuff. So these are all the scraps that I have from making that tropical plant just right now. And I'll draw it out for the first one so you can see. Get a big piece right here. And so basically you just cut out like a really, thin triangle shape out of them. So let me show you what I mean by that. And draw it on pretty thick so you could see. So see this scrap here and see this triangle shape right here? I'm just gonna cut that out of these. So I'm gonna make a stack and do the same thing I did. This is less steps because it's just like a big triangle shape. I'm gonna pick a few here. Okay, so I got three here. And here's a tip: when you're making plants usually grow in odd numbered leaves on them. So like 3, 5, 7, it looks more like a plant, I think. So I'm gonna do two more so that I have five aloe leaves coming out of this one. All right, so I got my little spikes. These ones are a little bit smaller, which is cool because it'll add a little bit more dimension to it. So same thing as the other leaves. If you fold them in half, it gives them more structure so that they don't flop around in the container. So you could just simply fold them in half and you got your little spiky, they don't call them leaves for cactuses. What do they call them? It'll come to me. Y'all know probably. I'm just gonna fold these in half to give them, like I said, to give them a little more structure. I'm doing this one a little out of order. I forgot to put my name on this. Oh, here, it's already on here. I'm just gonna cross my address out. Perfect, okay. And then I'm gonna just start placing the leaves in here. And because the container's bigger, I think I'm gonna put more in there just to make it look fuller. Cause this one looks like the little, it's gonna look like the little aloe that could. You know what, I'm gonna put these together in the corner. I'm gonna staple, just like the other plant, these three I'm gonna staple together like this. Oh my gosh, look at that. Carrie, very nice. Rihanna, very nice. Oh wait, no, who is that? Natalie and Liliana, very nice. Everybody's doing great. Okay. I stapled this together. And then you can see here, when we put it together, oh my gosh, it really looks like a cactus. And so I think what I'm gonna do is make like three of these little pods of aloe, so it looks like three aloes growing out of here. But for the purposes of the workshop, I'm gonna just stop at the first one, and then we're gonna move on to if anybody has questions. And then also I saw somebody wanted to know how to make a flower, and I'll show you like the easiest way that I know how to make a flower. So see, we have our little aloe moment right here, which is really cute. I'm gonna put some tissue paper in there just to give it a little texture. All right, and that's the second one. So we have our cactus and then our more like tropical plant here. And you can play with colors. I see you all have multiple colors, you know, put different colored leaves in there. If you have pipe cleaners, things laying around the house, you can make them into a plant or add them to the plant. And I have some really bright paper that you'll see the same color in the show. Because this paper, this color, this hot pink is so ridiculous and so Vegas. I love it. Okay, so I have this full sheet of tissue paper, and I'm not going to make the flower this big. Actually, I could to show you how to make one, but I'm just going to go like with the regular size. I don't like to measure stuff, which when you're making sculptures is not a good thing, but... It's just a thing. I don't like to measure things or make straight lines. So I'm just going to wing it, okay? And so just to show you, but that's okay because it's going to make the flower more organic, right? All right, look at those spikes, Rebecca. That looks nice. Okay, so I'm just going to cut out a rectangle out of this tissue paper. Oh, I forgot to mention, this is 8 pieces of tissue paper stacked up. So you get 8 pieces of tissue paper. You stack them up and you cut out a rectangle like this. It's like, it's a little, it's not as thin as the other one, You know, like the cardboard that I cut out first was kind of a thinner rectangle. This is more of a closer to a square than a rectangle, right? And you'll see why that is gonna kind of work in our favor for this. So this is 8 sheets of paper cut into a rectangle like this. All right, I'm gonna put this on the side. And then what you do is you fold it like a fan or like an accordion, right? So it's like about, I'm gonna do about 1 inch and fold. And then you flip the paper and then you do the same thing and you fold and you flip the paper and you fold until you go all the way to the end. And now if the, so I folded it and see how the end, there's just like this little bit of extra that's like kind of annoying. You can just fold that right in and then it just becomes this little accordion. So if like, if you open it up, it's kind of like a fan shape, but we want to keep it closed. And then what I do is I fold this in half just so I know where halfway point is. It's kind of hard to see from far away. Like that. And you could take a pipe cleaner at this point or a string. I think most people have strings laying around the house. In a pinch, I have been known to use dental floss for this. So I just have a regular string. And then, so you just tie the center of this little fan slash accordion, however you want to call it. And you just do a little double knot, not too tight. It's just so that it stays together. It doesn't have to be super tight. If you have a pipe cleaner, you can just like, you know, roll it in the middle so it stays because the metal will bend together. So there, I have like this little knot in the center. And then this is the part where you can get creative. I like to do just a very simple U shape at the top of this piece of paper. So you have the folded paper and you have the two ends here. And so I just cut barely any off the top, but just make it into a U shape. And that's gonna make the petal shapes. So you see there, can you see that? It's like very subtle. Some people like to do like triangles at the top to make like spiky flowers, which is cool. Whatever shape you want. Okay, so once I got that cut, now it's the tedious part of this. If it rips, it's okay. It's a flower. It's just gonna look like a petal anyway. So you open it up like this, see like a little fan. It's like two little fans on both sides now because you tied the center. And then one by one, you separate the paper. So I'm gonna pull it up towards me and I do one side and then I do the other side. And by doing that, it kind of locks the paper into place so that string doesn't slip around, you know what I mean? And then, so once I do one on both sides, then I just focus on one side. I licked my fingers. You're gonna be at home, it's okay. Don't lick your fingers if you're somewhere public right now, please. Okay, so don't do that. Okay. And so I'm just slowly opening up each piece of paper towards the first ones that I kind of folded towards the center. I have made thousands of these, so I'm making it really fast. If it's your first time, it's gonna take you a little bit. So look, so this is one side, like fully opened up, and then this side is still flat over here. So I'm just gonna work on this side really quick. Oh my gosh, I wanna lick my fingers so bad. Okay, here we go, I got it. Okay, cool. And then we have our little flower. So now that you've like taken the pieces of paper apart, like this is the bottom of it right here, and then this is the front of it. You could see it's like a very beautiful, almost looks like a carnation. If you cut it in a different shape, it could look like a marigold, like a Day of the Dead flower too. And so this is kind of like also they call them like pom-pom flowers on Pinterest. If you glue another one on the back of it, it makes like a circle and then you can hang them up. Okay. And so then if you put a stem on here or you just glue it directly onto your plant, it's a nice little addition to the plant as well. I mean, also I've been known to just grab a piece of tissue paper in a pinch to add a little color to something, like, and make a flower from just crumpling paper. So you just get creative. I didn't do a trial run of this, so we'll see what happens. But sometimes if you just grab a sheet of paper and fold it around and improvise a little bit, you can kind of just crumple the paper up and make a cool flower shape with it. Really easy. I don't have any yellow right now. Oh, I do. Here, I have a yellow pipe cleaner. So I just want to add a little bit of yellow to the center to make it look more like a flower. Just get creative with whatever stuff you have laying around the house. Put that in the center, wrap it around, and there you go. You have like a cute little tropical flower, just like that. And you don't have to do all that accordion stuff.
Okay, so Justin, that was amazing. Thank you so much. And I love seeing everyone's plants. We will open it up for questions. Your questions can be about your plants or if you have any question for Justin about his work. I saw in the chat box that people had asked about, can they bring plants to the museum that they've added flowers or they've added different colors? Yes, we want all of your plants. And like Justin said, please write your name on them, especially if you want them back. But they will be integrated into Sorry for the Mess, which will open up on January 21st. So your plants will be part of Justin and Romero's exhibition and part of the show in the museum, which is what we're really excited about, is having your guys' artwork in the museum too. So you can either raise your hand if you have a question and we'll unmute you, or you can type your question into the chat box.
Does anybody have a question?
Ask Becca to unmute.
That's funny. I was just going to type it in.
Oh,
Braden wanted to know what the coolest thing you'd ever made a plant out of.
Oh my goodness. The coolest thing I made a plant out of. There's going to be this plant in the exhibition that a group of us actually made. It's like a replica of one of my grandma's house, like fake. So my grandma has these big silver planters that she took from a casino after it closed down. So they're these huge like mirror planters, and then she stacked them with fake like plastic plants and has them like in her house or out front. And so I made a replica of that, but with kind of like materials or like whatever. So I use like aluminum foil, like a 5-gallon bucket and paper and just like scraps of metal and wire. And you're gonna see those plants in the exhibition. I think that's the coolest plant. When I saw those, because you'll see there's 20 different kinds of plants in there. And so I had different people make different plants, and it was really cool to see how some people made them, you know. It was awesome. Yeah.
Great. I made the great question.
I basically, when you see that, all I did was make the silver part, and then other people made all the other stuff, which was really cool.
Those are called artist assistants.
Yes.
Are there any other questions? Oh, will the recording be available? I had some connectivity issues. Yes. So actually after the workshop, we're going to take the different videos. Justin has a video in his studio right now. We did the video of just Justin speaking, and then we took a couple of video of you guys making your works because they look so great. And we're going to edit it, and it will be up on the website next week. We're shooting for Tuesday, right, Marcus?
Yes, Tuesday.
Oh, the podcast. Tell them about your podcast, Justin.
Oh, yes. I have two podcasts. One of them is called Latinos Who Lunch, and one of them is called the Art People Podcast. They're not really kid-friendly, so if you're listening to them, put your earphones on, parents. Latinos Who Lunch is a podcast with my friend and I, and he's an art historian, and it used to be very like research-based. Like we would choose a topic and kind of go into it. And now it's just us kind of catching up and making jokes and laughing and answering emails from listeners who are mostly Latinos. So a lot of identity crises in our inboxes. and then the other one is the Art People Podcast, which we'll be doing in collaboration with this show. And the Art People Podcast is my spin-off show that's just me interviewing folks or having fun conversations with folks, art people that I meet or that I used to meet when I traveled a lot, but now I interview my friends, and it's going to kick off again. Season 2 is over. Season 3 is going to start next year in January again, so that this collaboration will be part of that, the relaunching of it. Thank you. Thanks, Nathan. Oh my gosh, look at those colors from Suzanne. That's awesome.
Suzanne's a local ceramicist and sculptor herself. And I've been excited to see what she is gonna do.
Wow. Look at the height on that. Look at the height on Joyce's. Very nice. I don't know if I can see everybody. I can only see one page. I'm sorry. Oh, Carrie, very, very nice.
Emily. Can everyone do us a favor? I know that some of you are still working on them and you can keep working on them, but can everyone hold theirs up for us so we can take a look at all of them?
Cool.
Oh, nice. Oh, cool.
I love it, Laura. That looks great.
Wow, so great. I cannot wait to see these in the museum.
Yay. Wow, those look amazing. Oh my gosh. All right. Well, I know who I'm going to hire when I come work over here as my assistant. So cool.
So I said this before when we were kind of just starting out. We have a few kits left. So if you didn't have the materials at home and you don't know if you're going to be able to get out and get your own colors, your own materials, we have kits. So Jasmine pasted the lesson plan into the chat box. That has the materials that Justin used today. It also has suggested materials if you want to add to your material list or add to your plants. We're not going to have a cap on plants, so you can bring as many plants you want to the museum to be in the exhibition. Just like we said, please make sure you write your name on it if you want it back. And email us, and we'd love you to stop by and get a kit. We've got about 10 or 11 of them left. Or if you have any family, friends that you think would like to do this, please share this with them. Marcus is going to have this up on Tuesday for you to follow along again. And we are just really, really excited that all of you are able to join us tonight. This was so fun, Justin. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was the first time I ever did an online workshop. That was fun.
That was fun. It was really fun.
I feel like I could start a YouTube channel now.
You totally could.
Let me know in the comments. Okay.
Yeah. So, you know, you guys can keep working and thank you. Thank you all so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Carrie. Thank you, Emily. Thank you so much. Maria, that background, very nice. It's so nice to see people. I've been in my house for a full week. I haven't seen anybody.
Suzanne, I want to see that plant.
Oh, look at Tara. Tara's got a whole crew.
Oh, those are my neighbors. They're right down the block.
Oh, how cool.
Hi, guys. So cool. See, we've got
cool.
Three. Aw, sweet. Thanks, everyone. Come here.
You're calling her like she can walk over here.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you all. Thanks for coming.
Oh, look at her.
Oh my goodness. She's Hi, so Clara. Big.
Hi, Clara.
Hi, Clara.
Did you make a plan, Clara?
No.